Hi everyone, welcome back. January 2019, welcome to the new year. We've got the numbers for December and they weren't great. December was the lowest total sales in 18 years, going back to 2000, as reported by the Real Estate Board of Greater Vancouver. It was a slowing year in 2018 and a very slow month. December is always the slowest, so it's not terribly surprising that that happened. We are going to look at supply and demand. So in the condo market, we are actually still in a balanced market. We have been since September. Typically in a balanced market, we have flat-ish pricing. We have had some downward pressure on condo pricing, particularly from the higher end. And I think that that has largely been a bit of a recoil from just such strong price growth over the last couple years. So it is a bit unusual that we are in a balanced market with softening of prices, but we'll watch to see how that unfolds. We do have the busy spring market coming, so activity is going to pick up. So we're going to watch how that activity measures supply versus demand is going to give us an indication of where things are going to head in the next few months. Condo inventory remains well below historic averages. That's something important to keep in mind. Detached market has been in a buyer segment for quite a long time. Inventories are above the 10-year averages and buyer demand has been fairly low. That's a story that's been playing out for longer than in the condo segment. So interesting to see when those are going to level off as well. Could be sooner than in condos. The trend that we've seen over the last few months generally is we still have some investors just sort of taking profits off the table, not sure what's going to happen. We've had a lot of buyers coming into the market at what are much more attractive prices than we were looking at over the last couple years and actually positioning themselves really well into really attractive properties where we had the chance to do quite a bit of negotiating and pick up some really good buys. So it has been an interesting market benefiting buyers for sure. One thing I did want to mention moving forward on the more sort of macroeconomic level is that the Bank of Canada really raised interest rates aggressively in 2018, and they signaled that they were going to do that in 2019. That message has changed. As of December 5th, Bank of Canada signaled that they were going to be slowing interest rate growth, basically watching the housing market, watching the global markets and the overall economy. It now seems the language is that interest rates are going to stay flat with maybe a couple increases. Analysts are expecting one or two. A few analysts are even expecting potential cuts if we see weak numbers, but that's sometimes what people say just to get on TV. Last thought for you here. We talked last month about sort of herd mentality in real estate and buying and selling. If we look back at 08, there was a pretty extensive market pullback and buyers all went to the sidelines. And there was some real soft prices where a lot of buyers entered in when others weren't. Those buyers ended up looking really smart in the preceding couple years when the market turned back. So it's important to look at the long-term context of markets that go up and down. And when you have a prolonged climb, it's usually followed by a bit of a pullback. You have a pullback, it's usually followed by a climb. This is what markets do, they go up and down. So try and keep a long-term perspective on real estate when you're looking to make a long-term investment. It's important to look at these trends and it can really give you good context to make good decisions. Thanks for all the questions and comments. I appreciate the likes. Have a great day and we'll talk to you next time.